Motherhood. Let me tell you, motherhood will come and then it will shake you up, change you, and make you even look like a zombie. That's in accordance to our own songstress. Her name is Avril Nyambura. Now she did a candid interview with Alasi, and she basically said how she was very ready to be a parent 5 years before she actually became one. The problem, she didn't become pregnant. Those 5 years that she was ready to be pregnant is because she didn't have anyone stable in her life. She felt like she needed to have someone who she can co-parent and, you know, like, raise her kids with. Mm-hmm. And according to her, she found that someone, and finally, she struck the balance and had the child. Now, we don't know who the baby daddy is still, but when we know, we will definitely...
Allegedly. No, we know who we allegedly is.
Yeah,
we talked about it here on the show. We know who it is.
I do not know. Okay. So this is what she said: pressure and stress. That is when it comes to motherhood. You should respect mothers. When my son was a day old, it's when it hit me that I no longer had a say. And now, you know, you have to be very selfless. And she said, it will always be about him, as in now fully depends on me. In the beginning, I was a walking zombie because I could not get enough sleep. Even now, I still survive on very little sleep, as I also have to chase my dream. Balancing motherhood and work can be confusing, and it's easy to become depressed as one lands on the job. I was very ready to be a mom. I had been ready 5 years before I became one, but I never had someone stable in my life. So I wanted someone stable in my life so we can take care of the child together. So when the person I am dating came into my life, then the situation felt right, and he also wanted it, so he got it.
Okay.
Nimeongezea that part, he got it.
If you want it, you get it.
It is what it is. Yes.
Yeah. But it's true. Like, you know, hakuna mtu anaweza taka kuget mtoi na ukona tu msi mwenye.
Tukiholela, holela tu.
Ama mse tu mwenye ako, are you ready? Mtu mtashina mkisumbwana. You're like, you're not doing what you're supposed to be doing.
Yes.
So I feel like at the end of the day, kila mtu getingi kwa your space, and... sometimes it's earlier. Like, 5 years ago, she was ready.
Yeah.
But unfortunately, alipanga na mashura. So finally, akakuja kulan kwa prince. And she was like, you know what? Now you're starting to pop babies.
Yeah.
Well, you know, you go, girl.
You know, you're never...
The boy is like 3 years now.
Yeah, about
Aliza, yo kitambo.
Aliza, kitambo.
And she kept it hidden the whole time.
It's that fast.
Like 3 years.
I feel like it was just the other day I was seeing her and she was, you know...
Is it three?
Hiding it.
I think it's three or two.
It's about
that kind. I'm a Peter one. I'm a Peter one for sure.
I feel like I'll never mentally be ready to have a child. I keep telling Nana this. I'm like, I love kids. I'm great with kids, you know. Mm-hmm. But every time I think about popping out a baby, the things that happen to my private parts, you know, even just mentally being prepared to put someone else first 24/7, you know, being in a relationship, that's a whole different story. Putting someone else first when you're both adults, that's fine.
Yeah.
But like, I'm always between like, I'm ready, I'm not ready. I'm like, baby fever, I'm not ready. Baby fever, oh, my intestines will be rearranged. Oh, like... Are you never mentally ready?
Yeah.
For me personally, I feel like I'll never be mentally ready.
Yeah.
But you know, again, like I keep saying, the man's needs to come first so that I can start thinking about the children.
But let me tell you,
just go with
be
this.
Ready. Just get ready. Like when you know, just be in the right mental space and have the right person. At the end of the day, let me tell you, as long as you could be ready and you may think this is the perfect man for you that time and you may churn these babies, start chucking these babies out, but then you realize this man is not the man enough for you. What do you do?
Like,
nice, because you felt his wise.
Wow.
And then you start churning babies. Churn them, babies.
I feel like for me, I'm so excited about that chapter. I really want to be a mom. I really want to have babies. But yes, but I feel like you can never just be prepared to be a first time mom.
Of course, you'll never be fully ready.
But no, siwezi jirumia venye mimi jirumia zoniko peke yangu. Because niko na mse mwingine lazima niangalie.
A whole other person.
I'm just excited about that chapter. I don't know. Niko tu like, you know what? I'm ready. I'm ready to go. Vision 2023.
Hey, you guy 23.
We are here for it. We are here.
Do not worry, you'll be served tea.
Let me take you to our next story, which is about comedian and Nakada director Chipukizi. Now, he shared a picture of himself, you know, walking using crutches. So, of course, he revealed that he was in an accident, and he went on to say that he's never felt so many emotions go through his body at the same time. Let me just read what he said. When God speaks to you, hear, listen, and understand. Appreciate and live life. I know without a doubt we live by grace, the grace of God. We are not in control. You are not in control. panic, anxiety, and confusion all experienced in less than 30 seconds are the craziest things I have ever felt in life. It all happened so fast, and now it's 3 days nursing a knee fracture. The doctors say I'll be okay with time, but God basically told me to slow down. Take it a step at a time. We have been given life to live. My appreciation for life is over the top. I am grateful for life. Doing too much or moving too fast is not what life is about. Stop for a moment, live life. I am thankful to everyone who's been there for me, my family, my management, my friends. We slow down and appreciate. Wow, why do I keep saying appreciate? Appreciate life. Yes.
Wow.
Man. I didn't even know he was in an accident, man.
Me too. I watched that video with him walking. Yeah. Man, you never know how big those things that you think are minute to you are. Because honestly, he may alitoka tu. Akasume, you know what, si nimetoka, nimedrive, nimeenda job, nikapiga kazi yangu, na nitarudi tu home. You assume utafika tu. But sometimes you don't get to get home. And sometimes even when you get home, there's so many things that have happened along the way.
Between.
So at the end of the day, let's just stick to who and, you know, be grounded on the love of God, you know, and pray and just hope for the best at the end of the day. Because God utumirumia vitu mingi. Sometimes kuna battles zingine, si fight. Na asha tu fight here, we don't see them.
They are
unseen battles.
Yeah.
So I wish him quick recovery, man. Oh,
definitely, yes.
It's funny when life yo kuanga. One day you're here, the next
it's a completely different story.
And then no
story.
One is sure about the next. Mm-hmm. Like, literally, you don't know when your next is. Ineza kuangu ili kuanga inafai kufika kesho. Ama ni leo, you guess. So that's why I'm always telling guys, you get, instead of, you know, spreading a lot of negativity and being a bad person, try and live life the way, just assuming if tomorrow was your last day, unataka tukukumbukaje. Tukule mse mwenye likuanga nika tu pupu kila saa, kazi yake ni kutuka na wasi.
Una get? Una left tu hivyo.
What memories do you want people to have of you? Whether you're friends, your relatives, your family, or anyone who's around you. That's why I'm like, you know, be a good person. It doesn't kill you to be a good person. It doesn't kill you to spread. Hii dunia tunahitaji positivity, by the way.
Yeah.
Kuna tu shida mingi zenye watu wanakumbana nazo. But you tell us on 111-444-111 on SMS. But otherwise, we need to move on to life sports.